Yeah, and my students will join in another 5 minutes.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of the core team mental health webinar series and the organizer, Department of Psychology, the American College, Madurai, in association with Madras School of Social Work, Chennai, MS Chellamuthu Institute of Mental Health and Rehabilitation, Madurai, Redpond Educational and Psychological Research Center, Madurai, Psycho-Oncological Association, Turkey, we warmly welcome all the participants and resource person of today to topic 327 on physiology of meditation. Our resource person today is Ms. Sona Elizabeth, and I would request Dr. Suresh Kumar to introduce her to the group. Thank you, Sona, for being here, and over to you, Suresh.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Chandra.
Thank you a lot.
A very good evening, one and all. I'm happy to introduce today's speaker, and she's known to me as a student, and I can say, what is the word I can use? The fruit, chakka fruit. When you look at her in that, when she was doing like a tough guy, tough one, but when she's very quiet, sweet person in the class and knowledgeable person, I can say, and she's a writer also. And recently she was published one book. I thought of to get back, and definitely I will read it and I'll update you my review about it. And she's a founder of some mental health service provider. Right now she's working in Delhi as a life coach and a counseling psychologist, and she's providing elderly services and geriatric counseling. Very, very few of them will work on, and she's the one, she's specialized in that area. And I'm really happy to introduce today's speaker, and she's going to talk about physiology of meditation. So I was a teacher once upon a time, but I'm going to become a student for her today's session. I'm really happy to introduce Sona. Over to you.
Thank you so much, sir. That was a very warm introduction, and I'm very glad that I got this opportunity. And I'm seeing a lot of people here. So do they usually switch on the videos, or is it always like, do they don't?
Sometimes if they're having that good network, they will switch on.
Okay. Can I request at least a few of you to switch on the videos, because it's very difficult to... Hi, Sridhar. That's my friend. Hi. Because it's very difficult to speak to a blank screen.
Yes,
it would be amazing if I can see your faces.
And I think you are the first speaker you have requested the...
Really?
...channel the video.
Because I'll tell you very... Guys, the only thing is I want to see faces. Only then I can connect. And yes. I'm hoping this to be a very interactive session too. So please switch on your videos. I'm going to wait for a few more minutes so that I can see everyone. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much, Dr. Subhashree. Thank you so much, everyone who switched on the video. I'm waiting for a few more people to switch on the videos, because let me see more faces, please. Doesn't matter how you look. Doesn't matter at all. I mean, I know that everyone is so comfortable at their homes. So that's how I'm expecting to see you. So please let me actually see you and connect with you. Thank you so much, guys. Thanks a lot. All right, shall we start?
Yes, yes.
Perfect, perfect. And there is a chat window in here too, where you can actually put in your, it's there, right? Perfect. So when I ask you a few things, I'm expecting you to respond and, you know, give me answers so that I can take it from there. So before we start, I want to actually ask you a question. Okay, so the first question I want you to ask is, how do you usually start your day? So when I ask you, how do you start your day? It's not about the morning routine that I'm talking about. It's about the first thing that you do after you open your eyes. The first thing in the morning that you do, the first thing that you look for, or the first thing that you do. Yes. Thank you, Suresh. That was exactly what I was expecting. I'm expecting an answer from a few more people. If you can put it down in the chat box. Oh, who said not in a decent outfit? Okay. Someone said not in a decent outfit. I'm traveling, so the screen is dark. It's okay. But everyone who can switch on the videos, please, please switch on your videos. Dr. Subhashree is saying, can you put it down in the chat box? Okay. All right. I am expecting that a lot of people either drink a glass of water. That's amazing. Mobile scrolling, FB. Yes. That's exactly what I was expecting from the majority of people. So this
I
is
actually
what...
look at my, may I say that?
Oh, okay. who
I actually look at my palm, and also there isn't God nearby my bed, scene. So I look at that.
That's so
also.
Nice. That's so nice. I'm so glad that I'm getting to work with like an amazing group of people here, because most of the people would just say, I look at my phone. So here there are like really good refreshing meditation. Oh my God, there are already people who are doing it. So I'm so glad that this is the group of people I'm going to talk to today. So what happens when we wake up and when we look at our phone the first thing in the morning? Do you know what actually happens in our body? So okay, I'll just tell this to you. So how our body works is usually we start with so we have this hormone called serotonin that helps us wake up, right? So when serotonin is secreted in our body, so you know that our brain we constantly have brain waves, right? Our brain is continuously emitting particular frequencies. So when we are sleeping, we are in our brain is continuously emitting delta waves, right? So the moment serotonin is emitted in our body, our brain gradually moves from delta waves to theta waves to alpha waves to beta waves, which helps us to wake up. That much is clear. Give me a thumbs up if that much is clear. Perfect. Thank you so much. Now, when we sleep, the can you hear me now? Okay, perfect. Yeah, so when you go to sleep, exactly the opposite of this happens. It's I can hear, there's some disturbance. Can I continue? Perfect. So when melatonin is